pulsars are still a major, will be a very major part of the research done by the Square Kilometre Array. And the number of different things that have emerged from the pulsar discovery always give me great pleasure to think that, you know, you were the trigger that, and your work at Cambridge was the trigger that set this thing off. The going back in history, it wasn't long actually after the pulsar discovery that I received a letter from a graduate student in the United States. He was called Joe Taylor, and he was then a research student looking for something to do, and he wrote me a letter saying, do you think it would be a good idea to build an antenna array, something like this, something like yours? And I said, yes, I think that would be a wonderful thing to do. And I gave him a lot of support. But it was Joe Taylor whose research went on from that to bigger instruments using major facilities like the 1,000-foot dish in Arecibo, which led him on to using pulsars for extremely fundamental physics research. And because pulsars are such accurate clocks, they're immediately useful for testing Einstein's theory of general relativity. And one of the predictions of Einstein's theory is that if you wave sufficiently massive objects around sufficiently fast, they generate ripples in space-time. They distort space and time around them. And these distortions in space and time propagate outwards at the speed of light, and they're called gravitational waves. And there's enormous interest now and enormous amounts of money being spent around the world in various instruments attempting to detect these distortions of space and time. But the pulsars, because they generate such intense gravitational fields near them, that they become in themselves physics labs for testing general relativity. And Joe Taylor, who was a graduate student when he first wrote to me and got interested in pulsars, was finally awarded the Nobel Prize for demonstrating that gravitational waves must exist. In 1975, he discovered a pulsar which was in orbit about a neutron star. It became known as the first binary pulsar. And the orbit of these neutron stars is extremely rapid. They orbit each other in just over 7 hours, which is an incredibly close and rapid orbit. And they're generators of gravitational waves. And Joe Taylor was able to demonstrate from careful timing of his pulsar that over the years the orbit was shrinking, as orbits must if they lose energy, and it was shrinking at exactly the rate you would predict using Einstein's theory of gravitational radiation. So that Joe Taylor, it was Taylor and Hulse and his graduate student Hulse who discovered this pulsar, but it was Joe Taylor who actually used it to check gravitational theory. Over many years' observations, they found that the approach of the neutron stars was at exactly the right rate to be explained by energy loss into gravitational waves. You couldn't detect the waves directly as distortions of space and time, but you could detect the energy loss in them, and that fitted gravitational wave theory precisely to within a fraction of a percent. And Joe Taylor was awarded the Nobel Prize for that. Now, the Square Kilometre Array, when it exists, is going to follow up all sorts of different kinds of physics. At the moment, we know something like, we have discovered about 2,000 radio pulsars, radio-emitting pulsars in our galaxy. And with the Square Kilometre Array, many, many more are going to be discovered.